It is just announced that Softr is finally now integrating with SmartSuite. This gives all of us amazing new opportunities to build no-code solutions, and I'm really excited to unpack the new integration here in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting. We make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. In this video, we're going to be breaking down the new integration between Softr and SmartSuite. I'm really excited to jump into it, but before we do, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is one of the key pillars for building anything inside of no-code, and this particular training is going to help you understand the fundamentals of automation, regardless of what tool you're building in. Grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links wherever you found the video here. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. And if you want to follow along, I welcome you to sign up for SmartSuite on a free trial, as well as use our link for Softr so that you can get free trials for both of these tools and start building just as I'm going to do here in this video. So let's go ahead and take a look first at what I have inside of SmartSuite. I like to put no-code tools into different blocks in my brain in terms of the type of value they bring to the no-code ecosystem. And for me, SmartSuite is one of the most capable database solutions. It allows us to build practically anything that we can imagine and create the data schema to support the collection of that information. And so that's what I'm really leaning on SmartSuite for here. Now, on the other side, I'm going to be leaning on Softr as that front-end portal. This is another key component of anything we build in no code. How are people going to access the thing that you built? Well, we need to give them some sort of user interface, and for that, we're going to rely on Softr. So let's first dive into the data schema that I've built. It's fairly simple inside of SmartSuite. And once we move on past here, then we can look at how we integrate that with Softr and put together an actual web application. So on the back end, think of this as just a database. I have three key tables. Now, this solution is called BZG Mastermind. It's for goal tracking inside of a small private mastermind that I'm a participant in. And here we've got our goals table. Now, I'm going to share my goals because I'm not too worried about them. I won't be sharing the goals of anyone else as this is live and currently being used. But here I'm looking at creating some software. One of my goals of the week is to create some software that's similar to this software called Talkadot, but I'm going to build it with no-code solutions. I also want to create a landing page for speaking because, as it turns out, I've started to get more requests for speaking engagements. And then lastly, inside of Gap Consulting, we're hiring for a new role. And so it was a big goal of mine to make sure that we have our different interviews scheduled and that we go through that process. So the way this mastermind works is every week I'm submitting my goals, three goals for the week, and then I'm self-scoring myself on how I've done. So if I were to have to self-score right now, of course the week's not over, but I'd be giving myself a 2 on this, not very good. I'd be giving myself a 0 on this because I haven't done anything, and I'm doing pretty well on the interviews here. So maybe I'm at a 9 or an 8. So that's where I'm at with my goals so far for the week. Thank goodness the week isn't over, but that is what's happening here. Now you'll notice that I also have a link to the member and also a link to the session. So over here on sessions, we have when we have our different sessions scheduled. So we've got masterminds that are occurring every Sunday and we can keep track of them with the status. So is the session complete? Is it upcoming or the next session? And then, of course, we have our members table. Over here, I've changed everyone's name for this example, but you can see that we have our users here. We have people logged in, whether they're active members or not. So what I want to be able to do here is not force our users in this mastermind to log into SmartSuite. It would be so much nicer if they could just click one link, get into a portal, and have immediate access to their information, their goals, so that they can self-score, create new goals for the next week, etc. How are we going to do it? We're going to do it in Softr. So flipping now into Softr, I'm going to click on new application and I'm going to be starting from scratch. And you'll notice that I first get a request of what, you know, template pieces do you want to include here. I will just include everything for the sake of our example, but this is a really nice shortcut for you to get your app up and running more quickly. And in our case, I definitely want to list out my goals, and then I want people to click into those and see the details. So that's going to be our list details. And maybe I even want them to be able to submit new goals for the upcoming week. So we're going to use the form, etc. All right, let's go ahead and create our application here. And this is going to take just a moment, and then it's going to ask us, what do you want to use for a data source? And because SmartSuite is now a data source option, we are going to be able to link that up inside of our system. So if I click on our settings here and then over to our data sources, you'll see that we don't currently have a data source synced up to this app. So let's make sure that we get one going, yeah? So I'm gonna go ahead and click over to our list page. The list page is the first place where we're actually syncing up to some other data, right? Right now it has this example data that's not actually connected to anything. So when I go into this block, it's gonna ask me, well, what is your source? What is the source for your data here? Because right now I'm not actually showing you anything valuable. This is just some lorem ipsum, right? So let's go ahead and click on our source here. And you'll see that, of course, I have Airtable and Google Sheets, but I can add other data sources. And when I make that selection, here it is, SmartSuite in beta. Finally, let's make that click right here. And we're going to go ahead and say continue. Now it's going to open up in another window for us. And here's where we're going to need to sync up to SmartSuite. Let's go ahead and click continue with Google, because this is how I sign in to my SmartSuite account. Continue with Google pops up, and I make the selection that is associated with my SmartSuite account. It's going to take just a moment here. Now, once I click continue, you see I get this retry page that says the authentication failed. However, when I close this down and now I go into my application, I see that I've correctly synced up to my source here of SmartSuite. So a little bit of a bug probably right now that's being worked out in the beta testing. So don't take that too seriously. You'll notice if I click on solution here that I can actually drill in and see my different solutions inside of SmartSuite. Well, the one I want to sync up to for this particular web app is called BZG Mastermind Goal Tracking. There it is. So clearly I do have my proper sync all established with SmartSuite. And obviously whatever authentication failure I received on that last page is just an error. It's probably a bug again that's going to be worked out before you know it. So for me, I want to go ahead and sync up to my goals. So let's drop them in here. I'm going to set up goals, and we should start to see that goals get populated here on the side. Now you'll see I don't have anything coming in just yet. I want to first apply a bit of a filter. So I'm going to go ahead and say that I want the following condition to be met, that the person who filed the goal, the member, is me. I want to be sure that I'm picking myself here from the list. So if I go ahead and pop that in, is that going to be sufficient? Editing mode doesn't show accurate filtered results. To check whether your filters, I have to go to the preview. All right, let's try the preview. In order to get to preview, I just click right here, and that is going to open up a preview of the current work I've done in my app. And what I want to see is if it's going to filter just to my information or not. So it looks like it's having a bit of a difficulty in terms of linking it just to my different outputs. Let's go ahead and fly back into SmartSuite for a moment. And what I want to do is know what my member ID number is. So the record ID for each of these members, let's bring that information in. So I'm going to create a field here for record ID. And this is just going to demonstrate the record ID of each of these records. Okay, now I can look that up back into my goals. Let's go ahead and do that here. So I'll create a new lookup field here. And this is my lookup. It's gonna look at my members and bring in my member IDs. So rather than using the name here of the member as it appears, right, I'm gonna try to instead look at this lookup field. And I made a mistake by clicking on member ID. What I meant to bring in was that record ID. So this is the record ID that we brought in. And so give it just a moment to think. That's the record ID of me as a member. Because I only want to show my personal information here, let's now flip back into Softr. And rather than saying that the member is Gareth Pronovost, let's instead say, well, you know, we want to make sure that lookup that we found is a particular record ID. So let's go ahead and scroll back up to the top and refresh our data source. Anytime we make a change inside of the source data, if we want to pull that into Softr, we need to refresh it as we're building. I'm going to go down here and instead of saying member, I'm going to find that lookup field that we created, and I want the lookup to match my record ID. So does this work? Let's give it a shot. We're going to let it sync. And now if I preview, am I able to get the result I was looking for? I should have three goals established. Let's see if they show up. There we go. Now I have three goals, but I haven't picked what content is showing for those goals. So let's spit back into Softr and get to work on the content component here. So moving over to content, this is where I'm able to choose what is being pulled in from SmartSuite and shown here on my web application. So let's expand the first one, the image. I don't really have an image file inside of SmartSuite. Nothing here is an attachment or image, so I will probably just get rid of that component. By clicking hide right there, you'll see that now I'm just looking at text, which is more proficient for me in this example. In terms of the next component, let's look at this. I can bring in the goal description. This is where I'm going to have the particular information about that goal that I'm looking for. We can also open up this next component here. Let's add some other content here. I can bring in the date of the goal. I could bring in the feedback of the goal. You get the idea. The goal number I could bring in so that I could see goal 1, 2, and 3 for a particular setup. Whatever the case may be, when I'm happy with this, I'm going to preview it. Now again, I only have three goals inside of our system. So when I'm previewing it, it's going to show those three goals here because I've limited the availability of what's showing up based on the record ID. Now, just as you can with other data sources, once we've synced this up with our user table inside of SmartSuite, we can also filter information to be specific to the person who's logged into the application. How do we do that? Well, let's flip on back into Softr and take a look at our users. Inside of our users, we sync again with a data source. Once we make our selection, let's see if we can find SmartSuite from the list. We've got two options here. And inside of my solution, again, I need to pick where my table of user information lives. For me, it's inside of my BZG Mastermind goal tracking. And we have a members field here. And so we can map to the email field of a user. We can also bring in the name, allow them to create avatars, create magic links for them, bring in created dates, etc. All of this is available for any data source, but I wanted to show you that it's also, of course, available for SmartSuite through this new integration. Now, once we're all set up, we save and sync. And now we've created that synced up scenario with our users back inside of SmartSuite. So any users that we add to our SmartSuite members table here will be added automatically to our web application. They'll be able to access it as well. So back inside of Softr, we can now set up conditional rules on our lists. If I go back to my list page that we had been looking at and working on earlier, well, here inside of the list block, we can set up some different conditions. So maybe, for example, I'm setting up conditional filters that say, based on a particular user being signed in, then I want you to show their information. And this is all available because back here inside of our SmartSuite solution, when we create our goals, we link them to a member. And so we can establish rules that say members, when logged in, can only see the goals that are linked to them. This is the true power of building an interface inside of Softr. Any kind of web application becomes very conditionally available based on the rules that you set up. And I'm really excited that Softr and SmartSuite are finally integrated together. That's it for this video. I know we went pretty fast, so if you have questions, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.